go to images and then go to tools, size, go to large. Just, you know, have a big image of what you is looking for. I think I'm going to be looking for something like this. A Puma. Puma basketball. Could be something different, but... Alright. I already saved it. See that one there? So I already saved it. So I'm not going to save it again. So what we need to look now is for the Puma text. Either Puma text, either we can go to the font and get the Puma text. My Puma already have it. Or we can just grab the Puma logo. Something with a PNG or a transparent background or whatever. I would go for something like this. But sometimes that background with the checkerboard is on there. So sometimes that's hard to remove. But we're going to see if we can save this. Okay. Let me open this up and see. Okay. Okay, so we have the text. We have the photo of the purse. So now we want to get to working. We could do this in Marvelous Designer. But it'll be kind of harder to do. But we're going to try to make something work. I don't really need the photo anymore. Unless I need to look at it. But I doubt I need to look at it. So, okay, we're going to go ahead and jump over in photo. We're going to go ahead and jump over in Blender. With your Sims 4 avatar, we're gonna go down here to add. We're gonna add a UV sphere. I think 18. Do I need to go down to 18? I can't remember. Is it 18? No. Let's delete that. Let's go to add and go to cube. So we're gonna divide it by 2, and then we're gonna go to apply, go over here to edit mode. We need to find our knife tool. It should be under tools and go to knife. We want to click here, and press enter or shift. No, not shift, the space bar. Now what we want to do, we're still in edit mode, so A to deselect. Click this button here. Press B, highlight everything, the half, make sure you highlight the half, turn it around, press B again, highlight this half. If I can do it right, shit. Something like that. So we should have this. This should be all selected. Press X. Press faces. So we should have something like this. Now what we're going to do is go to the wrench, add modifier. We're going to go to mirror. So we need to mirror the X and the Z. Take off the X, mirror the Y and Z. And go to object mode by pressing tab and press apply. So now, back in edit mode, press this button here. We should have something that look like this. From here, I'm gonna go ahead and go to view, go to front. I'm gonna scale mine down. Even though I don't have to right now, but I'm just gonna do it. Now what I'm gonna do is go back in edit mode. Make sure I'm on edge select. I'm going to select these edges pressing shift and alt. We're going to select all these edges that you see me selecting right now. Turn it in the back. Make sure you have everything selected. Should look something like this. If not, you did something wrong. Let me make sure I have this one selected. Okay, I do. From here, what we're gonna do is we're going to go to mesh, go to edge, go to bevel. We're going to bevel this out, and then we're going to go down on our scrolly, our middle. Scrolly, let's go down to 3. I think that's 3, right? Segment, 4 segments. So, look something like this. What we want to do now is go to select, go to select more, select list, go to list. From here, what we're going to do is make sure we are in left or right view. Press S. And scale it in and press your left clicker. So we should be looking something like this. I'm gonna go ahead and put a material on mine. Go ahead and put a black material on that. This one is gonna be white. Okay. So if I get out of edit mode, go to object mode, this is what it's looking like right now. From here, let me see what we can do. Edit mode, press A. Press A again. We can do faces shade smooth. Now what we can do is go back to our cube, our basketball, go to modifier, add modifier, go to subdivision. This is one. So if we go to two, it'll be a little smoother, but let's just do one. Go to apply, go to edit mode, and we have something like this. I'm going to go ahead and put a color on my ball. So where I would want my bag. Or my sim. Probably like something like this right here. Okay, let's go to edit mode, go to A, see something? I don't like the black because I can't see what I'm doing. So I'm gonna make it white for right now. We're gonna add a torus. And we're gonna scale it down all the way down. Alright, so we got this. Go to edit mode, and we want to click this button here, limit selection. Press A, press B, and drag it out with the red. We get something like this. From there, I'm gonna make sure we on edge select, turn it off if it's this direction, hold shift and alt, click here, hold shift and alt, and click here. And we're gonna go over here to shading, go to mark scene, press A again, and go to unwrap. We're gonna rotate this. Rotate Y90. Try to line it up. Something like this. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and change the code. So, this is what it's looking like right now. So, what we're going to do now is we're going to mirror that torus to the other side. You want to go here, the wrench tool, modifier, add modifier, go to mirror. From there, what you want to do is mirror object. Right here, cube or ball, whatever you named it as, and go to Y, axis. So should be like this. Press apply. I'm just gonna start it from the bottom. Okay, add mesh towards scale. Edit mode. I modify a good array, and this one right here, bring it in about 0.7. Should have something like this, and we're gonna do a count of, I don't know, maybe 20. From there, we want to add, I think I want to add a circle, add a curve circle, I'm gonna scale it down, I want to view top view, sorry with all this other stuff in the way, okay. So we're going to edit the circle. So something like this. So we go back to the Taurus. I'm going to add another modifier. Add a curve modifier. And I'm going to click on curve. I think I want to add more of the count. Like 30. So on a Taurus, I want to move it to the middle, something like this, so it'll be lined up. I might want to add a little more, but see, it's going to add a lot of vertices. I'm going to go up to 40. So I'm gonna apply everything. I'm gonna delete the curve. And what I wanna do now with the chain, cause see the chain is upside down. So rotate. I'm gonna rotate X 180. Press enter. I'm gonna click on my ball. And I'm gonna scale my torus down. And I'm gonna try to line it up. Scale it down. Do I got it wrong, y'all? Don't tell me I got it wrong. Front. Yeah, I got it wrong. So now we gotta rotate it on the Z axis. Well, it's looking something like this. I wanna scale it down a little bit. I'm gonna go to edit mode. I want to select this one with L. Go to X, delete faces. Go to the other side. Press tab. Press A. Go to L. Go to L. Go to X. Delete faces. So this is what we're looking like right now. In case Blender do some dumb shit and crash. No, it will, child. Okay, so I'm gonna go to file. I'm gonna go look for my SVG right here. My image. Wait for it. Go to start. My school chief in college, and she has all the A's, and my youngest daughter was to download. See, it already downloaded it twice. Alright, so. Go to File, Import, SVG. Move this cube out the way. Move these out the way. Hide them. So what we want to do from here is we want to go here, shift click. Go ahead and get that out of there. And this, we want to put it probably down here. Like this. So what we want to do now is shift click everything. Including the, just the text, just the text. You want to go to Tools and go to Join. Now you join your text together. You should have something like this. If not, y'all don't know what you did wrong. So, from here, what we need to do is go to right here, data, object data. Make sure this is on 9. Go to convert to mesh. Go to edit mode. Go to A. Go to fill. Should have something like this. And remember, did it just flip it? It flipped my stuff. Okay, so let me go in the tab, edit mode, and go to shading, go to flip. And from there, what we want to do, make sure it's black. Okay, everything is black. Go back in edit mode. I'm gonna click on this. Oh, forgot. Click faces. Click this right here. Shift click. Click the other inner part. Go to P. And then you wanna select this. Shift select your other text. Go to edit mode. Press A. And go to, where is it, Tools, go to Knife Project, and go back here, go to Delete, go here, go to Edit Mode, press X, press Faces. So we should have something like this for your text. I'm going to go ahead and scale mine down. And I want to look at my cube. We're going to have to rotate this. Rotate Y, rotate X. So now, if we try to look at everything, this is what it has come to. Let me go to here. Let me change my material to, I'm gonna change it to black too. I'm gonna change this to take to Puma logo.
Closer after this, it seems like it has brought us a little bit closer.
looking like this. I was gonna put a zipper up there from Marvelous Designer, but I probably end up doing it anyway, but not right now. So this is what we looking like. I'm gonna go to my text. I'm gonna go to edit mode. I'm gonna go to A. I'm gonna go to E. And I'm gonna extrude it back. Go to tab mode. Go back to object mode. Edit mode. Make sure I got it looking right. From here, what I want to do is I want to put this text closer to the ball, to the basketball. I'm going to go to add. I'm going to go to curve. I want to go to pass. Scale. It's on the left side. Or is it the right side? Right side. Okay. Closer to the ball. Scale it down. Go to edit mode. Kind of make. Something like that. And just move it closer. Alright, so something like that. So what we're gonna do now is go back to the text logo, go to a modifier, add modifier, go to curve, cure, go to object, go to nerd. Alright. Move it over. Try to move it to the center. I'm gonna gonna go back to go back to edit mode. I wanna edit this a little bit. My text. I really need to edit the bottom. I think I might need to separate. Go ahead and apply this, and I'm gonna delete this. What I can do is go to object mode on my logo. Make sure this is right. Okay, edit mode. Let's click down here. Let's go to Vertex. Click down here. Go here. Click enable. Go to scale. Do I need to flip that too? Looks like I need to flip that. Oops, wrong one. Thank you. I'm not about to keep messing with this. So it might be too much. Let's unwrap this. Smart unwrap. Scale it down.